What is the minimum length we can measure using a regular scale? The normal scale which you use every day. Yeah, I'm talking about the 15 centimeter scale. This 15 centimeter scale can measure a minimum length of 1 millimeter, that is the minimum separation between its two marks. So the least count of our regular scale is 1 mm. What is the meaning of least count? The least count is the minimum quantity that the device can measure. Pierre Vernier attached an extra scale to measure the reading to a higher precision. How he did it? He took 9 mm on the scale and divided it into 10 equal marks. Now, the gap between two marks on this scale is 0.9 mm. He called this scale the Vernier scale. How can we measure even smaller length using a Vernier scale? If the standard scale and vernier scale are placed side by side, then the gap between the first mark on vernier scale and first mark on the standard scale is 0.1 mm. Similarly, the gap between the second mark on vernier scale and second mark on the standard scale is 0.2 mm. The gap between the third mark on the vernier scale and third mark on the standard scale is 0.3 mm, and so on. So if we shift the vernier scale by 0.1 mm, the first marks coincide. If we shift the vernier scale by 0.2 mm, then the second mark coincide. If we shift the vernier scale by 0.5 mm, the fifth mark coincides, and so on. So we have got a way to measure even 0.1 mm. That is 1/10 of a millimeter. Hence, adding a new scale makes the device 10 times more precise. The vernier caliper can be used to measure the internal dimensions, external dimensions, as well as length, as well as depth of a container. To understand how does a vernier caliper work, let's take this example. We fit an object between the two jaws of vernier caliper. Looking at the reading, you can say that the dimension of the object is greater than 1 cm but less than 1.1 cm. To measure the exact length over 1 cm, we need to find which mark on the vernier scale coincides. Here, looking at the reading, we can say that the sixth mark is coinciding. It means that we have to move the vernier scale by 0.6 mm further after reaching the 1 cm mark. So the length of the object is 1 cm plus 0.6 mm, which becomes 10 mm plus 0.6 mm. That becomes 10.6 mm, or one can say it to be 1.06 cm. We need to learn two things here. First, what is the least count of a vernier caliper? The least count, that is the least the device can measure. For the scale we have talked just now, the least count is nothing but 0.1 mm. But in general, the least count is nothing but the difference between the main scale division and the vernier scale division. So you need to remember this particular formula. The least count of a vernier caliper is nothing but the main scale division minus the vernier scale division. And the second thing we need to understand is how to take the reading. We say that the reading of a vernier caliper is nothing but main scale reading plus vernier scale reading times the least count. Now let's break out the terms here. What is the meaning of main scale reading? The mark just after which the vernier scales begin. That is the main scale reading. What is the vernier scale reading? The vernier scale reading is the mark of coincidence of main scale and vernier scale. And what is the least count? The least count is nothing but one main scale division minus one vernier scale division. So now let's do some questions the old-fashioned way. The first question, what is the reading of this vernier caliper? But I can't see, zoom it in. Okay, zoomed in. Now we know that the reading of a vernier caliper is given by main scale reading plus vernier scale reading times the least count. Okay, sir. The main scale reading is the reading just after which the zero of the vernier scale starts. So the zero of the vernier scale starts here after the mark of 1 centimeter. So you will say that the main scale reading is 1 centimeter. What is the vernier scale reading? Vernier scale reading is the reading on the vernier scale which coincides with one reading on the main scale. So here, which reading on the vernier scale coincide? You have to be looking very carefully. So you might identify that this particular reading coincides. Now, this reading on the vernier scale will be how much? So you will say, sir, this big mark is 5, next to it 6, this one has to be 7. So you will say that the vernier scale reading is 7. And the least count of the device is 0.1 mm. So we get the answer as the main scale reading 1 centimeter plus vernier scale reading, which is 7, multiplied by the least count, which is 0.1 mm. 1 centimeter can be written as 10 mm. So you will get 10 mm plus 0.7 mm. So the answer comes out to be 10.7 millimeter, or you can write it as 1.07 centimeter. Wanna practice more? See the next example. So in this example, you need to tell me what is the reading of this vernier caliper. Do remember that the least count of this vernier caliper is already told to us, and the least count of this vernier caliper is 0.1 mm. So you will say that, sir, look at the reading. Here, the vernier scale begins after this mark. So what will you take as the main scale reading? You'll say that, sir, the main scale reading has to be the reading of this mark. Huh? So how much is that? So this is 3. So this has to be 2.9. This has to be 2.8. So the main scale reading comes out to be equals to 2.8. Now the second thing you need is vernier scale reading. Which mark on the vernier scale coincides? Look very carefully. Which mark on the vernier scale coincides? So you will feel that this mark coincides, right? Now, what is the reading of this mark on the vernier scale? If you think that it is 4, you are wrong. Why? Because this first mark on the vernier scale is 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3. So the mark which coincides on the vernier scale is not 4, it is 3. So you will say that the vernier scale reading is 3. And the least count is already told to us, it is 0.1 mm. So the answer will be main scale reading 2.8 centimeter. Plus vernier scale reading 3 times the least count 0.1 mm. So what you get here is, in place of 2.8 centimeter, you can write 28 millimeter plus 0.3 millimeter. So that gives you, kids, 28.3 millimeter, or that can be written as 2.83 centimeter. Wanna practice one more? Let's do it. So now let's see the next example. Again, say that the least count of this device is 0.1 mm. You have to tell what is the reading. Okay, so let's look at it. So you will say that, sir, I just need to know two things. One is main scale reading and one is vernier scale reading. Here the zero of the vernier scale itself coincides with a mark on the main scale. And this mark on the main scale is how much? So you'll say, sir, this is 1, this is 2 here. So this big mark between them has to be 1.5, and this is just next to it. So this has to be 1.6. So you will say that the main scale reading is 1.6 centimeter. The mark on the vernier scale that coincides with a mark on the main scale, that is 0. So you will say that the vernier scale reading has to be 0. So the overall reading we are going to get is main scale reading 1.6 centimeter. Plus vernier scale reading 0 times the least count, which is 0.1 mm. So here you will get, bachcho, 16 mm plus 0.0 mm. So that becomes 16.0 mm, or that should be reported as 1.60 centimeter. Sometimes a student asks, sir, will there be a difference if I report the answer as 1.6 centimeter rather than 1.60 centimeter? Yes. What, sir? The difference will be this. Kids, the place up to which you report the answer represents the least count of the device. The least count of this given vernier caliper is 0.1 millimeter, which is as good as 0.01 centimeter. So the answer should be reported at least up to two places after the decimal if you are reporting on the centimeter scale, and the answer should be reported to one place after the decimal if you are reporting on the millimeter scale. So now let's practice out two questions based on finding out the least count. So the first question goes like, in vernier calipers, m division of the main scale coincide with m plus 1 division of the vernier scale. If each division of main scale is d unit, the least count of the instrument is. So the question goes like, m divisions of main scale coincides with m plus 1 division of vernier scale. M division of main scale coincide with m plus 1 division of vernier scale. Question is, what is the least count of the instrument? So sir, we already know that the least count of the instrument is nothing but 1 main scale division minus 1 vernier scale division. 1 main scale division is already told to us that it is d unit, and 1 vernier scale division can be found. How? They have told us that m main scale division coincide with m plus 1 vernier scale division. So you can write m times of main scale division equals to m plus 1 times of 1 vernier scale division. Substituting the value of main scale division as d, you will get that md equals to m plus 1 times vernier scale division. Hence you can say that 1 vernier scale division has to be equals to md upon m plus 1. Once this is established, game over. Now in place of main scale division, substitute d. In place of vernier scale division, substitute md by m plus 1. So you'll get the least count to be nothing but d minus md by m plus 1. Now this d minus md by m plus 1 can be written as md plus d minus md by m plus 1. These two md get cancelled. So what you get is d upon m plus 1. So the least count has to be nothing but d upon m plus 1. Let's see another example where we will find out the least count. The question goes like, a vernier caliper has 1 mm mark on the main scale. So the main scale division is 1 millimeter. If 20 equal divisions on the vernier scale, which match with the 16 main scale division. So 20 vernier scale divisions match with 16 main scale division. For this vernier caliper, the least count is. So again, start from the basic formula. You will say that sir, least count is nothing but main scale division minus vernier scale division. As per the problem statement, 20 marks on the vernier scale matches with 16 marks on the main scale. So we will say that if one main scale division is 1 mm, we can find out one vernier scale division using this idea that 16 marks each of length 1 mm coincides with 20 marks on the vernier scale. So you will say that 20 vernier scale division equals to 16 times main scale division. 1 main scale division is given to you as 1 mm. So you will say that 20 vernier scale division equals to 16 times of 1 mm, or 1 vernier scale division is 16 times of 1 mm by 20. Now, substituting the value of main scale division as 1, you get that the vernier scale division is 16 by 20 times 1 mm. Or 16 by 20 times of 1 mm is as good as 4 by 5 times of 1 mm, which is as good as 0.8 mm. So we can say that 1 vernier scale division is 0.8 mm. Now you know better what is main scale division 1 mm, what is vernier scale division 0.8 mm. So what is the least count? Their difference. So you will say that the least count has to be nothing but 1 mm minus 0.8 mm, that gives you 0.2 mm. So that's all in vernier caliper. Hope this will help you solve all questions that you are going to come in your NEET examination. See you guys. Bye bye.